Hello students, how are you all? I just hope that you all are good and you all must be studying at home. Now students, since I'm receiving your homework, I can still find that students, they are not paying attention towards the teacher's explanation and they are not doing their homework properly. So kindly take care of these things, okay? Students, let's continue chapter number 3, matter. Previously, I told you about what are the physical properties of matter. Today, you are going to learn about the factors responsible for existence of different states of matter. This means that how arrangement of molecules in different states of matter make them different from each other. Okay. So, here the first factor is intermolecular space. That means space between the molecules. So, In three states of matter, arrangement of molecules are different. Here in solid, intermolecular space. Intermolecular space, just now I told you that space between two molecules. Okay. So in solids, as you can see, there is minimum space or no space at all. In liquids, the intermolecular space is more than solids. Still, it is less here. And in gases, intermolecular space is maximum. Now students, the second factor which is responsible for the existence of different states of matter is intermolecular force of attraction. It is actually the force of attraction between the molecules or the particles, they attract each other with a force. And this force of attraction, it is very strong when there is minimum space between particles. Here you can see in solids, since particles they are close to each other, so the force of attraction will be very strong. And in liquids, particles they are loosely packed. So the force of attraction between the particles will be less strong. In gases, particles they are far apart from each other, so the force of attraction will be very weak. Okay. Now the third factor is movement of particles. That means particles they show movement. In solids, since particles they are tightly packed, so they move about their own position. In liquids, particles they are loosely packed and there's less gap between the two particles. So they are in continuous motion. In gases, particles they are far apart from each other, so they are in random motion. So depending upon the arrangement of particles in different states of matter, they have got different volume, shape, and their rigidity is also different. In solids, we can say that they have a definite volume, definite shape, and they are rigid because particles they are tightly packed. Liquids, they have a definite volume but they do not have a definite shape. They take the shape of the container in which they are poured in and they are less rigid as compared to the solids. And gases, they do not have any definite volume, they do not have any definite shape, and they are not rigid. Why? Because in gases, particles, they are far apart from each other. Now comes experimental study of the three states of matter, solid, liquid, and gases. Now here, through experiments, I'll show you how solids, they have got these physical properties or what are the characteristics of solids, liquids and gases and how they differ from each other. The first one is solids, and we are going to show that how solids, they occupy space. So this is how you'll be writing these experiments in your activity file. Okay, activity file, not in your notebook. So the first is aim. This is how you will write aim, then procedure, then observation, and lastly conclusion. And you have to show this with diagram. So the first one is to show that solids occupy space. take a measuring cylinder. We don't have a measuring cylinder here, but what I have here is this glass of water, okay? And and we have to mark it till 100 ml, and a solid is slowly immersed inside the cylinder. Now, as you can see that I have marked this level here, this water level till here, and now if I put a solid in this glass of water, then see, now this is a solid, and if I put this solid inside this glass of water, then you can see clearly that the water level, it rises up, okay, like this. And if I remove this liquid, sorry, if I remove this solid, then it comes back to its original level, okay. So it shows that solids, they occupy space. So in observation, you'll be writing here, the water level rises up above the 100 ml mark, and if the solid is removed, then the water level, it comes back to the original mark. So conclusion is that the solid occupies the space of the water and thus pushes the water level up, and similarly back to the original level on removing. Now, through an experiment, I'm going to show you that liquid, they also occupy space. And the experiment, the same experiment I'm going to show you that we did with solid, that here we have a glass of water which is marked here up till here, and if I put a solid inside this tumbler, then the water level, it rises up, okay, showing that water also is taking up the space. And if I remove the liquid, the water level, it comes back to its original position, okay. This experiment shows that liquid, it occupies space. Now, this is also an experiment showing that gases, they occupy space. So, this is how you'll be writing in your activity file. Aim to show that gases occupy space. Procedure, then observation and conclusion. Procedure, you have to take an empty glass tumbler which is lowered into a bowl of water. I'll show you this. Observation, on tilting the tumbler to one side, bubbles of air, they are seen coming out from the lower end of the tumbler. And then the conclusion is that air inside the tumbler is displaced and bubbles, they are pushed out from its lower end. Now I'll show you this through an experiment, okay. Students, this is a bowl of water, and instead of tumbler, I've taken this mini cup. As you can see, this cup is empty, and if I lower this cup here inside the bowl of water, over the water, and if I place it here and tilt the cup, then can you see this? The bubbles, they are formed. So it shows that the gases, they occupy space. How? Because the air inside the mini cup, it is displaced, and the bubbles, they are pushed out from the lower end, okay. So this shows that gases, they occupy space, okay.